friends, welcome to worship as we celebrate God's presence. And as we continue in this Easter season, the fourth Sunday, the Good Shepherd Sunday, also today we recognize that tomorrow is Earth Day. And this week our church is a part, our national church, and many churches across the country are part of remembering and celebrating Earth Week. And today, our youth will lead us in worship as we learn more about what we can do to help our Earth and environment, this home. Friends, special welcome to anyone who may be visiting with us today. Well, no, my cousin Pauline is here today, so he's a visitor. Carbonier. And also, we'll welcome those who are watching online. And we continue to give thanks that you can be with us in that way. For the life and work of our community of faith, I commend to your attention the goldenrod insert in your bulletin. Please note that tomorrow, our men's club slipper dinner is sold out. Yay! And there's a lot of sad people in this area today too. We couldn't get a ticket, but thank you to the men and expect to be lighting lots of candles around the church the rest of the week. So. Friends, I just joke. I hope serve tomorrow, but I will not eat. our board meeting is Tuesday at 7 o'clock in the boardroom, and it will be if someone can't make it, it can be done through online. Our coffee group is at 10 o'clock Wednesday morning. Inspiration band at 6:30. And our choir is meeting 7:30 on Thursday. And on Friday evening, the Cormier concert is at 7 o'clock here. And I will say the ticket sales for that is quite brisk as well. There are still tickets available. So please contact the office if you are interested. It's an evening of country duets, and it should be a wonderful evening. They do put up a lovely show whenever they're here. And the cost for the tickets are $25. At the coffee group, which are meeting Wednesday, part of their meeting together on Wednesday, we'll be discussing their afternoon tea, which is on Saturday, May the 4th, from 2 to 4. And I will tell you, if you are interested, don't delay in booking your tickets, because that is getting pretty close to sold out as well. Also, there's a craft fair next week at Talonites, one of our sister churches. And next Sunday afternoon at 2 o'clock, the annual Folk of the Sea service, which was a part of long-standing service associated with George Street United. And that will take place at Memorial United in Portugal Cove, St. Philip's. 2 o'clock next Sunday, and I know that one of the things is that the bell that is usually the ship's bell will be wrong there as well. So for those who missed that service, it will still continue. Also, the youth at Region, that means we have youth here who are of age today. There is a gathering for youth from around the province, grades 6 to 12, and you'll be staying at the university. You know, someone? And we'll be gathering, and anyway, I don't know all the details, but I know they'll be learning things and learning things about our wider church, but also doing some very fun activities together. And if you would like more information, you can contact Catherine Stewart, but you can contact me because I can get you a registration. And there is a cost to it, but I'm pretty certain our church will help you attend if you're It'd be a great way to meet other youth your same age. Those are, I think that's it. Mother's Day memorials need to be in by May the 8th. Those are my announcements. Does anyone have anything they'd like to share? I know Bob is back there. Bob and Debbie had a big anniversary yesterday. 50 years. Anyone else? Any birthdays or blessings? Just to remind you, yesterday the service was here for to celebrate the life of Ken Corbett and to continue to hold Jillian and family in your prayers. Those no further announcements. I would invite Sarah, who's going to lead us in our acknowledgement of territory.
We thankfully acknowledge the territory on which we gather on as an ancestral homelands of the Yaqut. We also recognize the land, island of the land, as the traditional homelands of the Yaqut and Mi'kmaq peoples, and that the original people of Ecuador are the Innu and Inuit. We strive for a respectful relationship with all the peoples of this province as we search for collective healing and true reconciliation, and honor this beautiful land together.
Thank you, Sarah. And Brianna is going to lead us in the lighting of our Christ. Thank you, Brianna. And friends, let us join in our intro, Like a Rock.
Whether we live near mountains or in fires,
going and singing our opening hymn, All Things Bright and Beautiful. I will tell you that the refrain, we will just sing the refrain at the beginning and at the end. So we'll do the refrain, we'll sing the verses, and then we'll do the refrain again at the end. In our actions, meditations, and prayers, may we honor and celebrate your good creation as we seek wisdom on how to share our gratitude and love in good, healing ways. We pray for your spirit to be with us. In Jesus' name, amen. Our first learning together today is a video just to teach us or to remind us today what Earth Day is all about.
What is Earth Day? Earth Day is an event which takes place every year on the 22nd of April. 1970 was the first year Earth Day was held. Earth Day was started to encourage people around the world to think and learn about what we can do to look after our planet. Well, there has always been was and does not get washed over, running into the rivers and seas. Planting trees, plants and flowers, these provide food and herbs for animals. They also help to create clean air for us to breathe. Recycling. Plastic, paper and glass are some of the many materials that can be recycled. There are more materials than ever that can be recycled now, so always make sure to check if you can recycle it before throwing it in the shop. Switching off lights when they're not needed helps to save energy. When you leave a room, remind your grown-up to switch off the lights. Other things such as TVs and computers can also be switched off when they're not being used to help save energy. Using eco-friendly products. Lots of things we use often are made of plastic. Plastic can be harmful to the environment. It takes a long time to break down and can harm planet surfaces. Instead, you can try to use eco-friendly products that are made from other materials such as fabric or paper. What about using less water? We can help to save water in many ways, such as turning taps off after washing our hands or whilst we're brushing our teeth. And outside, rainwater can be collected in large buckets or containers. This water can be used to water plants and wash cars or windows. We can do these things all year round, not just Earth Day. If we all make these little changes, we can make a big difference. What are you doing this year for Earth Day?
And Crystal is going to lead us in our prayer of confession.
Creator God, we know that much of your creation struggles. We begin to see and acknowledge the changes around us. We search for the causes and the cures and the collaborative ways we can commit to care for creation. We want to do what's right, but we don't always know what that is or agree how best to do it. Help us learn what we must. Listen to the diverse voices of creation itself. Help us understand and love what you have loved and called very good. Enliven that understanding, we ask. To allow ourselves to be moved to act as we should and to call actions that hurt. Guide us as we try to discern how best to truly listen to each other as well as creation and heed your call. We ask for forgiveness where we have taken too much or cared too little. For hearts willing to listen and change and will to follow through. May the knowledge of your presence and the assurance of your love shape our time here and always. We pray in your name. Amen.
Friends, good news is God sent Jesus to be amongst us to show us the goodness of creation, the goodness of each other, and God's eternal goodness and hope for us to live in abundance of living. And through Jesus, the Good Shepherd, we have been shown how to live and how to love. And through him, we are forgiven, we are renewed, and we're given the opportunities to live together in love and respect for each other and all of God's wonderful creation. And in thanksgiving, let us sing to God, O beautiful Gaia. I was thinking that for a second we were going to sing Bob Marley, but... A pocket there somewhere. I don't know about you, but with that video about Earth Week, I learned something that I didn't know before, that Earth Day has been around us since 1970. And I will tell you, that's the first year I went to school. And I never heard of Earth. All the way through growing up, I never heard once that there was such a thing as Earth Day. But apparently, back in 1970, there were a whole lot of people around the world, even then, who were really concerned about the environment. I do know when I was growing up, the big thing was, do you remember acid rain? That was a big thing. And the oil shortage, those were the only things I remember going in the 70s, back in the dark ages, that I knew anything that anybody spoke about anything with the environment, even though this was around for a long time. And when they had the first Earth Day, apparently there were millions of people who marched in support of the helping save our planet. And we know it's become a bigger thing all along, and the big news now is not acid rain, it's climate change. And we've seen how that has affected weather patterns, affected the sea life, the number of fires that we see in our country. Things have changed a whole lot since 1970. And it gets so overwhelming. And you know what happens when we get overwhelmed sometimes? We just say, I can't do anything. And I'm guilty of that last time. What am I going to do? One person. In a whole world of 8 billion people, what can I do to make a difference? But as our little video showed us, is that we all can do something to make a difference. We are reminded that we can make a difference through our God who loved us and sent us Jesus, who shepherded us into knowing the fullness of love and hope and life. The beloved 23rd Psalm assures us that God is with us and God guides us into everything in our world. And everything in our lives, and that God can lead us to help make a difference. Do you believe it? I do. And I'm going to show you one little thing that I can do to make a difference. This little looks like a pack of mints, don't it? What do you think it might be? You probably can read it from there. Blossoms? No. They do make a difference on holidays, though. It's a reusable straw. You got it. You know when you go to a store or you go to a restaurant now, and most places give you those nasty paper straws. No offense, I know they're better for the environment, but they are nasty when they start to looking like wet paper, is it? But this is something, but I do know that all those hard plastic straws that end up in the landfill is not good. Not good for the environment, and probably not good for animals that start picking at it too. So this is one way I make a difference. When I go and say, you know what, I already have my own straw, thank you. I don't want your paper one, and I don't want your plastic one. I have my own that I can take home and clean out. That's one thing we can do. What are some other things we can do?
Plant flowers.
Help our bees. Yeah. I didn't think of that this morning. This week, Earth Week, a lot of our ecumenical, with our United Church of Canada churches and some of our ecumenical partners are working together, the theme of acting, learning, and praying, something we can do for the earth. So I want us to think, what's something we can do as a church family? There's a lot of things we can do individually, like plant flowers, bring our own straws, bring our own water bottle. What's something we can do as a church family, do you think? Something we can do together? We can organize up a cleanup around the church. Maybe even a little bit broader. So I that's the kind of idea I had in mind too. So be prepared. We'll look at not Earth Week, for example, because we know that April is kind of a iffy kind of week weather-wise to do a cleanup, but maybe we could plan something for later in May or early in June where we can do a cleanup of our neighborhood here and maybe share together afterwards. So, you think it's a good idea? All right, I'll let you know who sets the date. But beforehand, I'm going to recycle something this morning. Which is another good way, right, to take care of the environment. Remember Easter? Our beautiful cross was covered in all those beautiful butterflies that Anna had made for us. Well, we took the cross out this week, but I saved the butterflies because they're too pretty, and they're too pretty not to share. But inside each butterfly, there is something that we can do. Like this one is a really good one for me. And maybe other people, probably people behind me in particular, reduce electronic use. Yeah. Because I do find there's a screen in front of me a lot of times, so it's a reminder, so I'll keep this one because that's a good one for me. But there's things inside, and there's things, a lot of them have the word pray on them. Just because you might go in prayer with God for creation. And ask what you can do. And you might be led into doing something totally new that you might not expect it, trusting in the Spirit of God. So I'm going to invite, do you want to help pass these out? Brianna, you want to take one side? Just pass them to people in the pews, and they'll just take one each, okay? See what those prizes are for you to do. So you just sort of pull up on one. I don't know. It's not always the same side, but just pull up on one side here and you'll get a little hidden message. You done, Pete? Helping yourself? Thank you. for sharing with us that important message. Thank you for sharing, even though you're down a couple numbers, a couple of members this week. A couple of our members of our group are sick this week, so I know some of you are doing extra duties, so thank you so much. Our next video is from our moderator of our church, the very Reverend Dr. Carmen Lansdowne. There's a message for us from the church.
For the second year, the United Church of Canada joins many other faith organizations celebrating Earth Week under the banner of Together for the Love of Creation. During Earth Week, April 21st to 28th, you are invited to initiate and participate in climate justice events, to pray and connect with the Earth, to learn and to share and to act for climate justice. Last year, more than 80 communities of faith participated. Together, we can make this year even bigger with wider impact. What will you do? Ideas and resources are available on our webpage. Join us as we act together for the love of creation. Friends, we can do that by the sharing of ourselves, the sharing of our gifts, and the sharing of our treasures to work together. We give thanks for all the many gifts to our church, through e-transfers, through car, and through all the ways that we are supported in carrying out Christ's ministry of love and justice for the earth. And so, here now, we have opportunity to give of ourselves. Our offerings will now be received.
we give thanks for the gift given in loving memory of Vincent Rogers from Ellen and Linda Parsons.
Thank you, God, for providing us with the wonderful earth moment by the stars on our days.
Bless these gifts given to help and sustain the earth and each other with grace and healing. In Jesus' name we pray.
Going to be led by Sarah, Brett, and Chelsea, so I would invite you to all get in place. When you hear God of creation, you're invited to respond, "Together we are stronger." God of creation,
together we are stronger.
And strength of your presence guiding us, we ask your love, in your love, to answer our prayers we offer today in the prayers of those across the church and beyond, acting together during this earth week. God of creation,
together we are strong.
May we continue to follow in the way that you are leading with hopeful and daring hearts until we reach your commonwealth of justice and peace. Amen.
Friends, let us join our prayers for the earth and prayers for each other. Be joined together with the prayer that was taught to us by our Good Shepherd Jesus as we pray together. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. sorry, affirm our faith in God as we make an affirmation for the earth. Friends, as we go from this place, as you go and experience each tree, and if you're like me, you're marveling this week that leaves are starting to come out, and each flower, beautiful crocuses, and the other flowers that are starting to, I think I even saw a dandelion the other day, which is a sign of spring. And you see each bird, the returning of the robins, and the bees that we're going to help by planting our flowers. And as you experience each of God's wonderful creatures, let us feel our God reflected in creation. And as we look upon God's world, let us share the love of Christ. And as we love one another, may God's Spirit give us the strength we need to care for each and every part of this creation. And go knowing God blesses you with all the gifts that we need to make sure that our earth flourishes with the goodness.